okay, I've marked this area at the center of the lips and down about a third of the way towards the bridle. This is the area we're going to finish the reed in. If we try just keep making the entire scrape thinner all the way along, at some point we may have trouble with the back D thumb note. This way we'll free up the reed and still retain a little bit of support that we need down here for a nice strong thumb note and good tuning. So the way to do this with sandpaper is to tip the reed a little bit more, and first I'm going to move the bridle upward or squeeze it gently with pliers in order to open these lips up. I want it to be more open than I would have it for playing, and that way it will concentrate the sanding right in that area. There, I've moved it up even farther and you can see the reed is quite open. I've got medium sandpaper now, so I will start level and tip up a little bit. You can see I'm starting to thin that. And then I'm going to look at the lips. Now, I don't know if you can see, but the bottom lip that I was just sanding is definitely thinner. And I'll do the same thing on the other side. Start level and tip it up just a little bit. And now it's time to test the reed. So I'll put the bridle back down. And let me just test it in the chanter. It's a little better, but it still gurgles on the bottom note. The thumb note is still very sharp, so I will do quite a bit more sanding. Then I look. And then I'll reverse it. Check the lips. Okay, that one's definitely thinner. Let's make sure the lips are closed. There, with the lips closed and much thinner, the way we like for playing, you're now hearing that classic double tone crow when I inhale gently. We are almost there, and the back D, it's now a little sharp, so that's all I'm going to do in this session. I will probably use the reed for a while if I'm a piper. As a maker, I'll let it sit in the box for another few days and then I'll come back and try it. If I overdo it and the back D goes flat, I can always trim a very tiny bit of length off the end, literally the width of a pencil mark is all you might want to do.